Now, will you notice as we come to this chapter, it's a very wonderful chapter. Let me read now, beginning with verse 1. And it came to pass when the king sat on his throne, and the Lord had given him rest round about from all his enemies, that the king said unto Nathan the prophet, See now, I dwell in an house of cedar, but the ark of God dwelleth within curtains. And Nathan said to the king, Go, do all that's in thine heart, for the Lord's with thee. Now notice the background of this. We have seen that David took Jerusalem, and David built there on Mount Zion his palace. Hiram, king of Tyre, built it for him. Then we saw last time that David brought up the ark to the city of Jerusalem. And then I think it must have been a rainy night in Jerusalem. The first night I ever spent in Jerusalem, it rained. And I thought it must have been a night like that when David waked up and he heard the pitter-patter of the rain on that lovely palace that had been built for him by Hiram, his friend. Then he thought of God's ark out yonder in a tent, and I suppose he maybe could hear the flapping of the tent. And he thought, my, I want to build God a house. And he then called in Nathan, his prophet, and divulged to him his heart. He says, I dwell in a house of cedar, but the ark of God dwelleth within curtains. Now, here's a case where a prophet was wrong. And I mean wrong, friends. Nathan said to the king, you go and do all that's in your heart. And I would have said the same thing. Fact of the matter is, if someone came to me or wrote me and said, Dr. McGee, we want to underwrite your radio ministry in a certain section or a certain station, I'll be very frank with you. I wouldn't say, well, now let me go and pray about this and see whether this is what ought to be done or not. I'd say, yes, this is what we want. May I say, it might be, it wouldn't be in the will of God. But Nathan here, I can understand how Nathan felt. Why, Nathan said, why, if you want to build God a house, that's the most wonderful thing I can think of. Go do all that's in your heart. But he was wrong. You see, David, as we've indicated before, he's a bloody man. Long before he ever committed that sin, he was a bloody man. God had said, you can't build me the temple. It is in the heart of David, and God gives him credit for it. And I think that we make a mistake calling it Solomon's temple. Solomon never built a temple. David gathered the materials, made all the arrangements with the contractors, and Solomon just carried it out. The only temple Solomon ever had is on the side of his head. It ought to be David's temple.